Greetings, I am Lime.
And I am Scandal.
And let's play a game together. In fact, let's redo an episode together.
Yeah, let's replay a game together.
So somehow, just like happens very occasionally with the large volume of work that we put out, we lost episode 17.
Yeah.
And fortunately, we still had the video file, but the sound file was gone, so we know what's supposed to be in here.
Yeah.
And we're gonna do our best, but if it feels just like it's got a little bit different energy than the one sandwiched around it, that is why.
Yes, because right. I'm not gonna lie.
I'm Lies.
I'm
sorry this whole thing happened to you, but if it's any consolation, the bad lady is gone, and I don't think she's going to ever come back. And I'm gonna cover what I cover here before, going, I don't really like the language Lies is using, suggesting that some adults are just bad people.
Right.
Like, that is the bad lady, rather than, you know, that was an unfortunate situation and it doesn't look like she's gonna be bothering you anymore, but specifically labeling her a bad guy.
Right, well, and I'm also still frustrated with the fact that it's like, again, our first thought is to go use security footage and that we know how to use the security footage
and how to get
into it. I'm
still baffled by that. I think that's amazing.
Like, whoa.
And additionally, like, Lies is also in a position of going, I think this is the answer, but doesn't bring anyone in on it. Because you don't take everyone in with you. You take three people who are at odds with each other, leave them alone together, run away to do something mysterious, and then come back.
Especially with, like, leaving a poor child there to potentially get intimidated by an adult.
Additionally,
that is hardcore shit.
Yeah, I was gonna say, so I didn't think Lies handled that very well.
No.
The boy, cheeks still streaked with tears, lets a smile spread on his face.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Oh, hello, baby.
Thank you. Except for I can't boy voice right now.
No, it's okay.
The boy scurries off and rejoins some of his other friends.
You know what? Boys can sound like anything, and you should not discriminate against your boy voice.
It's true, but the one that I usually associate with young anime boy voice, I can only pull up once in a while. And so
it's true.
That one. Like, I can't be Trunks right in this moment.
Oh, my pain is real.
It's okay. So actually, I met the actress who does Trunks.
Right.
And who's done a number of other young anime boy voices.
Right.
And she's like, it's funny because that voice that I do for, you know, Trunks, I've had to do for like 100 different animes. She's like, so many people are just like, just do be Trunks, but this character, you know?
Uh-huh.
And she's like, and then one time I got hired for this really big anime, and I forget what it was because I didn't care about it, but her performance was great. I love listening to her talk. And she's like, and then, you know, it was really British. And they had Cockney, and she's like, just do Cockney Trunks. And she's like, so I did Cockney Trunks, and now there's basically out there somewhere an AU of Trunks that's Cockney. It was good.
That's so good.
Anyway, so to join some of his other friends. Case closed.
We assume.
Mm, right. That sorted out. But the other two situations are about to spin out of control, because no one else works here. Oh, I've only got time to handle one of them, I think it said.
Oh, whoops, sorry.
It's all right, we're good.
It's okay, all right, we're good.
Two kids fighting over box cupcakes near Naomi and Ashley. A little girl crying over her stolen tickets near Percy and Gavin. Now, the thing is for me, like, the cupcake one bothers me because we never do learn the food rules in this arcade.
No.
Ever. And one of the most important rules that I've learned at every job I've been to is whether or not you can have food there and where you can have food if you can.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, this job not covering that at all just bothers me so much.
Yeah, it's a little...
like, I'm just like, it's as well as, like, the ones, some places that have food, it's really only our food, no outside food, that kind of thing. And mm-hmm. I'm just like, So we're going to take care of the little girl crying over stolen tickets because, like, Naomi and Ashley, in theory, should be able to handle some kids with some cupcakes.
Yeah.
Like, if you already have two other employees there, you coming over as a third employee is probably not really going to be, like, the difference that's required.
Yeah.
You know? All right. So
well, you know, but we're the magical character. We can solve all problems.
Oh, I'm
all
sure.
All times.
I weave my way through waves of children towards the skee-ball TM machines.
Oh, no.
One little girl. Oh, she's really cute.
She's
still really,
really
cute. Last time she was super cute. This time she's super cute. I also love the logo on her shirt. I don't know what it means, but I love it.
Also, I am still giggling because every single one of these characters, spoilers for everybody in the past that's dealing with this right now, you will see them all later. And it's still a super cool thing that the Arcade Spirits game does.
It is. I mean, I don't know that we see all of them again later, but we just see quite a few of them again later.
Yeah.
It's really neat. Like, the side characters, it's great.
Yeah.
One little girl sitting at the end of a skee-ball TM ramp, crying. No parent in sight to settle her. So the task falls to me, because the only people that can take care of children are professionals and their parents.
Yeah.
That's it. I'm guessing I should be more cautious about this sort of thing. What with lawsuit happy parents lurking over by the vending machines, ignoring their kids. But see, the interesting thing about this whole experience, and I thought so last time, so I'm just going to put it again here this time, is that the game is judgy both of the state of the children as basically being annoying and a nuisance.
Existing,
and
yeah.
of the way the parents handle them by not paying attention to them or taking good care of them. So it's like, do you think the kids are the problem? Or do you think the parents are the problem? Or are you really just like, in this moment, arcade spirits hates people.
In this moment, both things are true.
I feel like it
feels like it's also lacking some nuance for that. And like, it was kind of like our surprise with, you know, the whole birthday thing to begin with. Going like, why is there such basically abject terror / universal dislike
of kids and everyone, and assuming that this is a completely relatable social experience of kids.
Blah.
Anyway, ignoring their kids. So Liza is not only like, terrifying kids, but also I will judge the shit out of parents. Like, this character is very judgy of those parents. It's amazing.
True.
Florentin at last decided to take the case. All the same, I will risk life, limb, and lawsuit for this child.
I will do it.
This precious baby who is sad. Hey, my name's Lance, and I work here at the arcade. What's wrong? Can I help? Her sobbing pauses as she looks up at me.
Oh, I lost my tickets! Someone stole them from me!
Hi.
I played and won a bunch of them, but then I put them down and I was talking to a friend and now they're gone!
I glance around, but in a sea of kids, it's impossible to tell who the thief could be. I mean, yes?
I don't even have any more tokens to play with. I spent spent them all on Skee-Ball TM, and my tickets are all gone now.
Anime crying.
Tears everywhere. Whoa, honey.
Fountain.
Just pouring.
Gushing.
From the sides of the eyes. Just foosh.
Blah.
Easy. We'll figure this out. Somehow.
Somehow.
A way. There will be a way to figure it out.
It will occur.
Although, I've got no clue where to even start, to be honest. Maybe there was a witness to the crime. Percy would have had a good view of the redemption game area, except that he would have been on his game staring at it.
Yeah.
And if there's actually a sea of children, the odds that he would have seen that specific activity while staring at the screen, paying attention to his high score, doubtful.
Also, again, customer, not employee.
Uh-huh. I did not read the next part of that line.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you
That's
did.
That's okay. No, I didn't.
I'm
sorry. It's okay. You keep thinking that when I read half the line, I read the whole line.
Yeah, because you just stop.
All right. Would have a redemption game area based on where Moopy's positioned.
Based on the position.
So based on the position of the game, but I still doubt it. Also, again, yeah, customer not responsible for doing business stuff.
Absolutely. Right.
Gavin has a ticket desk, a veritable crow's nest for the whole arcade. He could have spotted something, and he's actually an employee. One of the interesting things about this game, and it continues throughout it, is this experience that we sort of treat the other regular customers as if they're employees, and it starts on this very first day.
Yeah.
And we never seem to really change that. They basically function as unpaid employees as far as Lias treats them.
Which gives you a weird sort of, I don't know, like for me, I'm kind of like, that seems a little inappropriate. Because they should be getting paid for
doing job work.
Yeah.
And the thing is it's like, it doesn't seem like anyone else really treats them like employees. It's just a thing that Lias does.
I know.
And it's a little bit of a wild choice, to be
honest. Except when you look at it later, so again,
now, there are
spoilers,
always,
everybody
always
does. No, I was going to say that later, especially, you kind of have these weird scenes that seem to imply that the employees and the customers really do hang out quite a bit. And I understand getting to know your regulars, guys. I've worked in retail. I get it. But, like, to me, it's a little strange. Like, I'm sorry, I worked at McDonald's for 2 years, and I never, like, obsessively was like, oh, yes, I will friend all the regulars, and especially the man with the see-through pants.
Oh, God. Or, you know, the people who sit there on the touchscreen game monitors all day long, like they're gambling and buying, you know, one drink refill to nurse all day long.
Yeah.
And you go and you get to know those people and hang out with them outside of work. No.
Yeah, no.
No. And arcades, of course, are a little different than fast food, but that's a thing that I've never done either. Like, I just don't really get to know people. Like
maybe
that.
Horrifically, I am just not all that social, shockingly.
Who knows? All right. he could have spotted something. Or I could just bend the rules and solve this directly. How do we even know what the rules are? I'm still complaining about job training, which we never got.
Yes.
And the thing is like, I'm not surprised that you've had failed floor attendants if you equip them with zero training
at all.
Like, that is not surprising to me. Okay, maybe Percy saw something. Gavin had to see where the tickets went. Just give the kids some replacement tokens for their own stash.
Via arcane policy.
See, the thing is like...
I would love to have more policy.
I was going to say, the thing is yes, we did choose Gavin last time, and it makes... I mean, the character hasn't changed. We're going to choose him this time. I just was like, just give the kids some replacement tokens. So the problem with that is, one, it's from your own stash. If you're giving replacement tokens, it should be part of arcade policy, right? And two, you can't guarantee she'll get the same number of tickets for those tokens.
Nope.
When I've had basically arcade staff help me out with things or help out other people in the arcades I've been in, it's really a sense of, how many tickets do you lose? And they just comp you 300 tickets.
Yeah.
And they really go, let's go spend them at the prize counter right now kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
And they really just walk you over there and go pick out whatever you want.
Yeah, because
or they'll just print out the tickets for you.
You guys, I gotta tell you, the prizes are really balls-ass cheap.
They are. And the thing is like, they really will, like in most places that I've been, if you have a reasonable case for something was stolen or lost, they will just give you tokens if you lost tokens, give you tickets if you lost tickets, or let you just choose a prize. So we're gonna go to Gavin and see, and at least find out a little bit about our job as far as like arcade policy, whatever. He's basically our boss,
right? Because that's what he is.
Nope, not gonna mess around with this one. A theft is serious business.
Serious.
This is not joking business. This is serious.
This is a two-tit situation.
All right, wait right here, okay, kid? I'll go get help. We'll get to the bottom of this. I promise.
Okay.
I love how she just trusts you. Okay. Like, her hair is so cute.
I love her hair.
Her hair
is super fabu, and I bet you her parents, they do work hard.
They take good care of her hair.
And again, if she just has a parent, that's okay too.
Okay.
They work
Who's
hard on
ever
her.
Helping take care of her is doing a great job with her hair.
Yeah, excellent.
Since she's supposed to be like 5 or 6.
Yeah, no kidding.
I duck through the crowd, which makes me really damn short, since most of the crowd's about hip height. I duck through them.
It sounds a little
weaving
wild.
My way back to the ticket desk.
We get down
and do the little knee up by our chin funky walk through the crowd.
Oh, no, we're doing the crab walk. Yes, let's do that too.
Okay, back to the ticket desk. Hey, Gavin, that girl over there? Boy with the red hair, currently playing Frogger TM. He took her tickets when she wasn't looking.
Aww.
I am still grumpy about that. Wait, you saw?
Certainly.
Of course. What of it?
Excuse me, sir.
Okay. Why? So, we felt this way last time and we were a bit outraged. And Liza's just like, wait, you knew? And you didn't do anything to help? Like, you were right there and you saw it happen.
You had the power, sir.
You could have also just went, hold on 1 second at the counter, walked over there and been like, son, those are not your tickets. Because doing it later... People often go, you didn't see me, you can't prove anything. But if you walk up right after and go, hello, I just saw what you did, there's a lot of shit.
You know? Like that is a different mindset that you catch people on.
Uh-huh.
And I hate to do stuff like that, like personally, like I get it. Because sometimes, so usually when I see people do behavior like that, to me, it mm-hmm. screams a lot of basically fear of missing out or basically fear that I won't accomplish something and that I will not have something
that I
clearly
won't
want.
Get enough or have enough. There's that kind of thing. I would say,
so,
hang on. Wait a minute. You saw this kid take the tickets? Yes.
I believe that is what he said.
And you didn't do anything at all about it. First, I'm tied down at the desk, which means I can't tell anyone they have to wait over here, because that's important.
And we don't have walkie-talkies, because fuck modern technology,
am I right? Well, you know what? That's expensive. This arcade is bargain basement, okay?
Oh my god.
It's all hands on deck, Laz. Nobody out of position. Not even for a minute. No peeing for anyone.
You will
ever
all...
Hold it and suffer.
You will all become the poor man with all the Reddit man who goes off about... Oh, God, if you heard the one about the cum shirts and the 2,000 liters or whatever the hell it is of pee?
No.
Oh, God. So there's a story on Reddit about this guy. He gets lazy and he decides that, you know, he's just gonna stay at his home office. And you should just look it up, okay? Just
and
look
pee.
It up.
Okay.
Yeah,
anyway,
it's
don't
fine.
Worry about it. It sounds
and now
creepy.
He's like, and now my wife wants to divorce me. It was on accident. He didn't, according to him, he didn't do it on purpose kind of thing to like
it
be weird.
It sounds gross.
He was just
fine.
Being gross, basically, I won't clean up after myself sort of thing.
At any rate, the thing is like,
experienced.
I'm just as experienced of imagining in their break room a sign that says penguin in there and one that says hold it for your life.
Oh god! You will pee your pants.
You will not pee your pants.
You will not.
You will stay in position and not pee your pants. Not even for a minute.
Doubtful.
Second, confronting the boy won't do any good. He'll clam up and refuse to even admit wrongdoing. Yeah, but not if you catch him immediately. The thing is if he thinks you saw because you're on your way over there while he's pocketing them, people react differently, okay?
Uh-huh.
I have known shoplifters, and, like, not closely, but definitely have. Mm. And the thing is if they're caught, but you're going to, like, basically let them return it and let them go, they're done. Yeah. All right.
Or also, honestly, there are still people who just go, you caught me even later, and I still feel bad.
Yeah. Well, I mean, the thing is it's the, I don't want to be legally in trouble. If I can just give you the thing back and we're done, can we do that?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. And parents can be twice as immature, I found. Right now, I just want to keep the peace. One girl crying is less of a disturbance than a boy throwing a tantrum.
Except that to me, they're pretty
Except for
equivalent.
He's literally saying, girl crying is not a problem. Boy screaming is.
Yeah.
She's crying quietly, so she's not being, her pain isn't that big of a disruption. He's a lot more entitled than she is, so he'll be a real pain.
Yeah.
Going, I really,
what?
Dude?
Yeah.
Dude, really? The way he stands there so stoic and uncaring, why that girl in pink just sobs. It's not right. I mean, seriously, it's not right. But he's my boss, and it's my first day. How hard do I want to push this?
He is your boss.
All right. Let's see. Can't say I like it. No.
Oh,
call
and that's a good
bullshit.
Point.
Bullshit. I thought you were all about supporting others' dreams. And Gavin, have a heart. What makes her sadness less important than a boy's potential tantrum? And that is a really good point, and I liked it last time, too, of mm-hmm. going, you don't know the boy will throw a tantrum.
You do not.
You're guaranteeing his experience, basically, against hers. And his isn't guaranteed, and hers is.
Yeah.
All right, have a heart. What makes her sadness less? Come on, Gavin. So you let one customer feel like crap just to avoid having another customer? Maybe feel like crap? A thief, may I add? There's keeping the peace and there's allowing suffering just because it's the path of least resistance.
Yeah, pretty much. And that's
yeah,
actually a really
cool.
common thing. Like, oof.
Honestly, it really is. And the thing is almost every job I've worked at, they'll let some kind of a thing or a policy slide if they think it'll be less drama right now.
Yes.
And most of that is just because there's a level of going, I don't want to enforce policy because I didn't enforce it correctly, thoroughly, hard enough at the beginning. And now I'm not trained to communicate with people, so I don't know how to do it now without just seeming like a jerk.
Yeah.
Or trying to flex power, if you will. We're losing a customer today regardless, which is a heck of an assumption. I'd rather not break a little girl's heart to do it, and let a bully learn he can do what he wants. At first, it looks like he's going to chew me out for standing up to him.
I love the fact that it gives itself away with this by going, at first, it looks like.
Right? Going, instead of just being like, the look on his face is this, and then. If you start with at first, it tells them that's not actually what's happening.
Yeah.
And that it does resolve, so we don't get to have the terror that you know, Elias has for a second, the real resistance.
Yeah.
But, you think me a monster?
I hadn't intended.
Of course I feel bad about this. I feel bad for her, and he shouldn't get away with it. I'm just trying to protect the arcade, as a whole. Then do it. Protect the arcade by protecting the gamers and their dreams. He sighs, like a stress relief valve yawning open and closed. He's like, but it will
Indeed.
Be difficult.
Yeah,
you're right. Of course. The weird thing is, like, he says, of course, right here, which bothers me because, like, it acts like we've had some kind of rapport established before.
I
like,
know.
You're right, of course. Instead of just being like, that's the right position, of course.
You know what? You're right.
Like,
that's all you have to say. You know mm-hmm. what? You're right. I should do something.
Uh-huh. And it's interesting that it sort of feels like, of course. Like, you know, you're always right. And it's like, you don't even know us yet.
Yeah.
Apologies.
Focusing on the big picture does tend to leave me apathetic to each individual brushstroke. My apologies, lass. I'm lucky I had you to put me back on track. Your predecessor wouldn't have stood up to me like this and shown me how wrong I was. Now, let's get this out properly. Let's sort this out properly. I can read. There's that kid.
Here we go.
Gavin walks right up to the kid, who's busy hopping a frog around in traffic. Wouldn't mind seeing this kid go play in traffic myself, which I think that line
is really aggressive.
Aggressive. Because, like, That is not like a, I wish this kid would just get out of here or something, you know, or basically that he would have a bad day. That is literally, you could go die for all I care.
Like
that's rough.
Yeah. That's
what... Boy.
What do you want?
Can't help but notice that roll of tickets in your pocket. Big winner, are you?
Also, I'm
he
like, this setup.
It directly
this
at all.
Setup is bizarre because I, like, really, as far as I've ever seen, basically anybody confronting about something, you go, hey, so I've had a complaint mm-hmm. and I was watching you in this thing. Like, you just lay it out there. Like, uh-huh. they're not dumb.
And you really can even just be super honest and be like, I saw you steal a girl's tickets. She's upset. You need to give them back. What are you talking about? It was a few minutes ago. I was busy. I only have time to address it now.
Right.
Like, I've even done that with kids, been like, hi, this incursion happened a little while ago.
Mm-hmm.
And they're like, well, you didn't see it. And I was like, no, I did, but I was busy over here doing this other important thing.
Uh-huh.
And a lot of times kids are really understanding of that. And especially if you come up to them, you know, just different kids that I've met and are like, hey, I'm going to be respectful of you, but I need you to accommodate this rule.
Yeah.
And sometimes they'll push back being like, I don't like other adults. But I've always managed to be that weird, cool adult going like, look, I don't like adults either. Nonetheless, my birthday was before yours, so what are you going to do?
Hey, honey, I'm older than 18.
But I, you know, meaning I,
oh, yeah.
I would be your age had I not been older. You know?
Right.
All right. Are you?
The biggest got them all playing that spinny color game over there. See?
Really? It's funny. See, I own that game. May I see your roll, please?
Like, honestly, this is an interesting power move, but it's also frustrating. So we'll get there. Hang on.
It is. It's convoluted.
Yeah. I didn't want to show you.
Well, I can see the end poking out of your pocket there, and I see the serial number on the ticket starts with a 1. Which is interesting, because the roll I loaded into the color spinner, it started with a 2.
I think not.
Meaning those tickets were 1 playing skee ball, specifically by that girl over there, and you took them.
DM.
Which, that doesn't actually scan at all.
No.
Because it doesn't mean all of those things. That's like a Sherlock connection, and it makes, you know, it tells people that the world works in ways that you will never understand, and there will always be another secret that you can never, you know, never account for. Not like, hey, I saw you take them, give them back. That was a dick move.
Yeah. Again, I'm like, his buildup is a little strange. I feel like they're trying to be, like, he's very exacting
or something.
I was going
to say, using some level of basically investigative bullshit magic, if you will, even if it is cool awareness and him going, even if that, whether that's true or not, it's a neat way to approach it.
Right.
As far as, like, intellectually is concerned, going, ha, I have outsmarted the you.
Yeah.
But on the other hand, it doesn't teach the kid anything about, life
mm-hmm.
and about handling things and going, hey, by the way, you took someone else's stuff and hurt their feelings.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm way for more for, like, teaching people empathy rather than going, let me intellectually one-up you and have the, you know, basically mental high ground.
And I was also going to say that, too. You really aren't basically going, hey, you see that person? They're really sad because you hurt their feelings by stealing the thing that they earned.
Right? Or
you know,
whatever it is.
Right? You're a liar. Leave me alone. I'll yell for my mom.
Seriously?
Do you really want to risk having your mom believe me instead of you? And then he uses basically, I am an adult. Other adults will believe me. It just feels a little immature.
And it's also like, it's very dismissive of children, period.
It's dismissive of the boy in his own position going, obviously you stole those for a reason. But you need to just understand you need to give them back.
Mm-hmm.
Like, we are not here to be your parent, but also, yeah, this is level of 1, I am smarter than you and have the higher ground, and then, oh, she'll believe me over you. You are not an important person.
That's really kind of shitty.
And it feels inappropriate.
It's also pitting the kid against their parent. Like, can you imagine?
And going, your parent isn't going to trust or believe you, which is wild.
Whoa.
Like, that's a little bit of an intense premise. Instead, how about you give me the tickets and walk away? At first, the kid looks like he's going to shriek bloody murder, but a few nervous glances at his mother, busy munching chips by the vending machine, where I judge parents again, change his mind.
Take him! I don't want him anyway!
He angrily stomps away, presumably to go play some other game on the other side of the arcade.
Huh. Hey! Yay! Hey! You did it! You found my tickets!
I found them. We aggressively, you know, repossessed
them
back. Yeah, he went and repoed them.
Yes. Yes.
The girl actually hugs me. Well, hugs my leg. Anyway,
thank you.
Everyone here is hip high.
Tiny.
Thanks so much. Thanks and thanks. Yay!
Now then, let's get you your prize. What is it you wanted? And that one I'm familiar with, of going, now that your ticket problem is solved, let's immediately have you spend them so it can't repeat itself.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Crayon!
Those we have. Les, I'll take it from here.
Yay!
All right.
We've done it!
Ooh, that's a fuzzy happy feeling right there. But no time to rest on my laurels. I've got other arcade dreams to defend. I'm the defender of the arcade.
Whee!
Two problems in the can. Now to deal with that cupcake problem. Too late. The vintage Midway cabinet Naomi just finished fixing up. It's covered in icing. Which... And again, there was two other employees there. If they couldn't handle it, it was ridiculous.
And
not like a third adult doesn't help. But they're experienced employees and we're not.
So, and I also had a problem with this when we first recorded it, and I'm still confused going like, I appreciate that sugar can be destructive and I get that icing sucks and getting shit on, you know, nice vintage cabinets blows. But it's like, they usually have sealants on them?
Yeah, it's not usually just like painted on there.
Uh-huh.
It's usually a big decal that's got, you know, a plastic seal over it.
Yeah.
And you just wipe it off.
And that's one of those things, especially, like, for Naomi, and they realize this sort of thing happens, I'd be like, that's why they tend to have, like, floor displays versus not floor displays. Like, whoa, different stuff.
Looks like Ashley's costume is gonna need dry cleaning, too.
Oh, dear.
I shoot him a hopeless look and shrug.
Helpless. Helpless.
Hey, Lies. Kinda wish it was the pink icing. Then nobody would notice.
Sorry about that. I wasn't quick enough.
You still helped out. I saw you with those other kids. You're a natural.
Yay.
I think things are winding down anyway. Why not take a break? And then I'll swap off with you and take a break myself afterwards.
Sounds good.
We have already made our break time. Whoa.
Honestly, I'm kind of worn out. Ashley's right. I need to step away from the craziness, if only for a few minutes. After a silent nod from Gavin to confirm it's cool with him, I slip away, headed to the employee lounge.
All right, well, we are now out of time. Well, actually, we got to the end of our previous episode, and so in order to keep this where it is, this is where we are going to stop.
Yes.
So thank you very much, everybody, for joining us. If you like what we do, please feel free to like, comment, subscribe, and also share our videos if you're having a good time with us. Please also feel free to go check out our Ko-fi and our Patreon. We have some links in the description down below. And I have been Scandal!
And I have been Lies.
And it was great playing with you. Bye!